the real content of any kind of revolutionary thrust lies in the principles and the goals that you're striving for, not in the way you reach them.
The question is more, how do you get there?
Oh, is that the question you were asking?
Yeah.
First of all, if you're going to talk about a revolutionary situation, you have to have people who are physically able to wage revolution, who are physically able to organize and physically able to do all that is done.
To eliminate the term diversity from any budget requests in 2018 from the CDC is questionable.
It gives you a pretty good roadmap about what they're going to try and defund.
Here we've got a study, and they concluded that the stress that comes from societal racism has an impact on our health, on our children, on our lives.
I'm a bad bitch. You can't kill me.
It's difficult because we come up in households where we don't really pay attention to family issues. Like, we so much on the hustle and trying to get the money that family becomes second and money becomes first.
But intergenerational and present-day experience of racism is at the root of not only black infant mortality, but in terms of our cancer mortality rates, in terms of diabetes,
high blood pressure. If you were engaged in disease prevention strategies that involve going into a community and making sure you were talking to a minority community, what they're letting you know is that, you know, forget it.
I would like to see hip-hop address it more. We're so powerful as a culture. Enough of us have died for us to look into it.
The revolution wasn't televised in the 60s. Is it going to be televised in the 90s?
Well, you know, the catchphrase, what that was all about, the revolution will not be televised, that was about the fact that the first change that takes place is in your mind. You have to change your mind before you change the way you live and the way you move. So when we said that the revolution will not be televised, we were saying that, like, that the thing that's going to change people, it's something that no one will ever be able to capture on film. It'll just be something that you see, and all of a sudden you realize, I'm on the wrong page. Or I'm on the right page, but I'm on the wrong note. And I've got to get in sync with everyone else to understand what's happening in this country. Uh-huh. But I think that the black Americans have been the only real diehard Americans here, because we're the only ones who carried the process through the process. And being born American didn't seem to matter.
And she told me, she said, you know, thank you for the times where, you know, we came to performances and this is like really meant a lot to me. You know, she would.
Wanna take a minute?
It's difficult as a black man because we come up in households where we don't really pay attention to family issues. Like, we so much on the hustle and trying to get the money that family becomes second and money becomes first.
As somebody who's been suicidal, as somebody who has battled depression, I would like to see hip-hop address it more. We're so powerful as a culture. Like Hov said in the interview, we move things. Enough of us have died from mental health issues for us to look into it.
And that can draw a thin line, you know, between you having your sanity and you losing it.
Loneliness is a terrible, terrible thing, man. And if you don't know how to conquer it, it can eat you alive.
I'm specifically speaking to us and about who we are and how do you maintain the sense of self while pushing it forward and holding us to have a responsibility for our actions. Like, rap is about the gift of discovery. Mm-hmm. The white hot space is when it's fresh and new and it's like, this is the hottest song ever. And At the end of the day, we're going to find out it's not about the white hot space, but it's about finding the truth. Mm-hmm. That white hot space, people think is the biggest thing, but it's really small. Mm-hmm. It's almost like a trend.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Like, so knowing that and understanding that changes life completely. And you can't sacrifice others for your life. Mm-hmm. You know, there's a debt that has to be paid. You can't just, you know, turn your back on the place you come from. You come from the community. Your job is to uplift it now. I mean, it's like if we had a power base together, it would be a much different conversation. Because the goal is not to be successful and famous. Mm-hmm. That's not the goal. The goal is, if you have a specific God-given ability, is to live your life out through that.
Mm-hmm.
You know, the most beautiful things are not these objects. The most beautiful things are inside. Mm-hmm. To expose your feelings, to be vulnerable in front of the world, that's real strength. Mm-hmm. You can be inside your body and be happy, but at the core of it, something else is going on. Mm-hmm. You know, you feel like you gotta be this guarded person. That's not real, mm-hmm. It's fake. And so my whole thing is to identify with the truth, because you can't have a solution until you start dealing with the problem. And what you reveal, you heal, you know?
Mm-hmm.
I want what's best for people. So we have a responsibility to identify with everyone's struggle and to know these people made these sacrifices for us to be where we are, to push the conversation forward until we're all equal.
Mm-hmm.
Until we're all equal in this place, because until everyone's free, no one's free. And that's just the fact.